Good morning and welcome to Morning Message for September the 2nd. Well, it's been a couple of weeks since I've done one of these morning messages. I had a couple of weeks of holidays and really enjoyed it, feel good and relaxed. Although when I got back to my desk here, there's an awful lot of work to be done in the next few weeks and some things I have to catch up on. But that's okay. I like to be busy. But I have to tell you that I was thinking over the holidays about what September was going to be like for us in the church. And one of the things that I've noticed over the last few months is that the scientists, the doctors, and the people who have been leading us through this pandemic, the language seems to have changed a little bit. They're not talking about the end of the pandemic or moving beyond the pandemic. They're starting to talk about living with the pandemic. And that's a source of concern for all of us. And I'm sure that in the weeks, months, years ahead, we'll continue to get advice about how to protect ourselves and how to protect one another through this COVID-19 issue or whatever it might be that we're facing in terms of communicable diseases and that sort of thing. So we have to live with these kinds of things. And I think that impacts how the church reacts as well. When COVID-19 was initially a thing, the churches closed down and there were several months there where we weren't sure when or how we were going to open up again. And so St. Paul's parish here in Charlottetown took the initiative of doing a survey and trying to find out from our congregation what they expected to be in place before they would return to in-person worship. And I think principally we had two areas of concern that were raised by our parishioners. First and foremost is that we follow whatever protocols happen to be in place on any given day. So whatever the government scientists tell us we should be doing, we need to be doing those things. That was a clear message from the results of that survey. The other thing was that some people said they weren't going to come back to church until vaccines were widely available. And, well, they are. And when you look out at the congregation, when you think about who's in the church, not everybody who was there before the pandemic has returned. And so it's a natural concern for us to say, well, what needs to happen now to increase that comfort level or desire on the part of those people that haven't returned to come back to church, to in-person worship? We're going to continue to live stream our 10 o'clock services on Sunday morning service. Our Sunday morning service will still be live streamed, and we encourage people to watch that. If you're home, not feeling well, or whatever, tune into the worship service. We would certainly ask people to continue to do that. I think that has proven to be a really effective way of connecting with people. And we've really appreciated the feedback, sometimes the immediate feedback that we get, John's mic isn't on, something like that, but also the general impact about how people are taking those services. We've really enjoyed that kind of response that we've received from people. So it's a good method of connecting people and connecting people with their spiritual journey. But there's something inside of me that kind of suggests that in-person contact is even better. That sense of being in community, that sense of being with one another, is even a better way to connect with the community. And I think perhaps in some measure to connect with that spiritual journey that all of us happen to be on. Humans need contact to be healthy, but I think humans need contact with one another also for that spiritual journey to continue to mean a lot to us. So if you haven't been back to church yet, my email address and the office phone number should be at the bottom of the screen. So I encourage you to email me or call me and let me know what the what your concerns might continue to be. And I realize some of that might be personal circumstances in terms of other people in the household maybe can't be fully vaccinated or something like that. All sorts of issues like that might be there. So call me and let me know that. And if you don't have this, these numbers are for people who belong to St. Paul's Church. If you don't happen to belong to St. Paul's Church, give your local priest a call, or you know, a parish leader, a pastor, somebody. Call them and have a conversation with them about why you're not returning to in-person worship just yet. So that if there are things that we can do, if there are things that we can make that experience a little bit more comfortable for you, I'm sure that every church that could possibly be around in terms of the breadth of people that may be watching this video, I'm sure that leaders in all of those communities would like to know what issues are still facing people in terms of that. So please give me a call, send me an email, let me know what you're thinking and feeling about this. And I would say, even if you've heard something from a family member or friend, you know, let me know what they're saying as well. And that could help parish council here make some informed decisions about how to proceed. You know, here on Prince Edward Island, sometime by the end of September, there's not supposed to be any restrictions if everything continues to go well. But there still may be some issues that we're facing in terms of our comfort level in terms of being in public, whether it's at worship or somewhere else. So please give me a call, send me an email, whatever, and let me know how you feel about those things. And in the meantime, I hope that this day, which is supposed to bring lots and lots of rain tonight and tomorrow morning, I hope this day is a blessing to you. God bless. Amen.